recibir este gran evento, un evento muy bonito y muy grande.
And to be able to share with all the personnel and behind the scenes that made this event a great event, such an unforgettable event possible.
El evento de Halloween.
And the event of Salvador.
Para mí estar aquí, pues, gracias a Dios, siempre habíamos pensado en un día posiblemente íbamos a estar aquí.
For me, thanks God, we've always had dreamt of the possibility and the thought that we might be able to make it.
Porque la verdad es que cuando mi médico profesional conoció, no pensaba que iba a estar aquí.
To be honest, when I signed to go professional boxing, I had never dreamt that I would be sitting here.
Pero según fui avanzando en el camino y ganando campeonatos, ganando medallas importantes.
But as through the journey, as I kept winning fights and gaining championships and important fights.
Sí, sabía que posiblemente ella estaría aquí.
Then that's when I started realizing that, you know, maybe it would be possible to be here.
Gracias a Dios que trabajamos duro.
Thanks to God, we worked really hard.
And
I had a very strong team working with me all the time. And I had the most important person to be with me day to day in this career in boxing.
Que es mi padre,
que
es mi entrenador,
mi entrenador y mi manejador.
Mi padre es Félix Trinidad, que está que me acompaña hoy.
My father is Félix Trinidad, who is here. Give him a senior.
Gracias por tirar el nombre.
Dale, número uno por igual.
Y el domingo va a ser un día muy emocionante para mí, un día muy bonito para mí, para mi familia.
Sunday is going to be a very emotional, a very beautiful day for me and my family.
Porque definitivamente el premio puede hacerlo.
Because to be honest, I've had world championship titles,
grande victoria,
great victories,
pero el domingo es la victoria más grande.
But Sunday is the greatest victory I've had in my career.
If I may, I would like to ask your father to just say a few words about his feelings of his son being inducted. Felix, can you? Senior, welcome, and we would just like to ask you, since you are such an integral part of your son's career, through his whole career, your feelings and your emotions of seeing your son going to be inducted into the Hall of Fame.
And I want to make clear and make sure that it's understood that we're very grateful for all the opportunities that God gave us.
What we're going to do now is, I know some of the fans are just chomping at the bit to ask our Hall of Famer our champs some questions. So let's start right back here with this lady.
Hi,
UNC.
Congratulations, first of all. My question has to do with your 1994 fight with Hector Macho Camacho. The old lady recently passed away, so. So my question to you is how was it like you fighting in the ring number one, and what are your fondest memories of Hector Macho Camacho?
Can you read the first part of the question?
Before in 1994, so my question to him is, how was it like to fight him in the ring? What was it like? And what his fondest memories of Hector Macho Camacho?
It was a very good fight. And in which I won by unanimous decision by the judges. I was facing a fight with very strong experience. Who had fought with a lot of champions.
I
knew it wasn't going to be easy. But I went with the mindset and ready to get the victory that day. Then exactly January 29th of 94.
Y gracias a Dios que era, ¿verdad? Porque sabemos que era falleció.
And thank God, even though we do know that unfortunately he did, he has passed away.
Pero un gran ser humano.
He was a great human being.
Un gran boxeador.
Great fighter.
Y el mundo del boxeo siempre lo trae nada.
And the world lost him everything. Question.
Congratulations to you. Just want to know your most satisfying victory in the ring, your career. Just want to know your most satisfying victory in the ring, and who's the top ultimate that you would like to fight now when you're currently fighting?
Okay, take it.
question right over here. Question right here.
Congratulations, just like everybody else is giving you as well, and many best wishes. My question is actually for your father. When did you know he had something special to give to the world of boxing?
From early on in his career. He demonstrated the qualities of a world champion. And the title of world champion, one of the best ones, as he has demonstrated in his career.
Jim, another question right here.
Tito, quiero darte las felicidades en este gran día para ti. Ha sido una es un honor estar acá enfrente tuyo, haberte visto seguir tu carrera tan cerca y ahora tenerte enfrente. La verdad que no sé qué decir, pero me siento muy feliz.
I don't know what to say. I'm very happy because I've been able to be a witness to your career, all your fights, and now you're sitting right in front of me.
Una pelea que nunca se dio fue una pelea con iForce. ¿Por qué razón no se dio esa pelea? Y si se hubiera dado, ¿cómo describirías tú esa pelea?
One of the fights that never materialized was with iForce, and what would have happened? What do you think would have happened if that fight had happened?
Exactamente la razón por qué no se dio. No sabría decirle 100% por qué no se dio.
The exact reason why that fight was did not materialize, I can't give you 100% certainty why exactly.
Pero mi padre que está aquí al lado, estoy totalmente seguro que puede contestar esa pregunta.
But my dad was right here next to me, he could definitely answer that question. That fight actually was so we had planned that fight for the end of 1998, but the court case lawsuit with Don Quinn at that time impeded us from being able to throw the fight. So after things got fixed in the relationship with Don King, then we decided to move on and go after the Whitaker.
A question over here, Champ, to your right, all the way over here.
Tito, primero que nada, saludo. Solamente quiero saber si te acuerdas de esta pelea, ya que me lo ganaste igual que a Valga. ¿Te acuerdas cuando le ganaste a Whitaker?
Sí, me acuerdo. Pues sí, la
yes, I do remember the Whitaker fight for
28.
I remember that day.
Okay, we've got a question from none other than Hall of Fame favorite Marlon Starling, everybody.
I only have one question, by the way. If I come back at the end of it, go back. When I come back at the end of it, go back.
No.
If Marlon said when he comes back as a heavyweight, then the two can fight.
Ah, que cuando regrese como eso. I want to say some few words.
Okay.
Earlier when I was speaking to all of you.
no estaba conmigo aquí, sí estaba en Cali, pero no estaba todo el resto del grupo de la familia.
The rest of my family wasn't here present when we started right now this conversation.
Amistades.
Friends.
Y parte del grupo que estuvo conmigo durante mi carrera de boxeador, que de verdad que siempre, como te dije ahorita, son parte bien importante en mi carrera como boxeador.
And part of the team that was always with me during my entire career as a boxer, they're now here present.
Y quiero, sí, mi familia, quiero que seguimos, no sé un poco difícil pasarlo acá al frente, pero sí mencionarlo y que pueda ser la madre, ¿sabes?
Obviously, it would be really hard to ask all of them to come up with us, but I want them to be able to mention them, to acknowledge them, and if they can raise their hands, so all of you guys can meet and turn around.
Sunday, the 8th of June.
I'll receive an honor that I award that I share with all of you.